Do you have a burning desire to meet your Nabi? Well, you have the power to actualize that desire. On one occasion, a companion came to the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said to him, O Messenger of Allah, I love you dearly. I love you more than myself, more than my family, more than my children even. And sometimes when I'm at home, I think of you. And I just can't wait to come and see you, just to look at you. However, sometimes I contemplate regarding my death and your death. And I know that you will be raised with the Anbiya, given a high status. And even if I am to enter Jannah, I will not enjoy the same status which you enjoy. And therefore, I will not be able to meet you. With regards to this, an ayat of the Quran Kareem was revealed, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَنْ يُطَعِ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَصِدِّقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ That whomsoever obeys Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and obeys the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then they will be with those which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has showed His great grace upon. And who will it comprise of? The Anbiya alayhimu salatu wa salam, the people of truth, the martyrs, and those which are righteous. Unfortunately, we were not able to meet the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam in this world. We do not live in the era of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. However, the decision to meet Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the Akhirah lies in your control. So next time the thought crosses your mind, it's just a sunnah, or but Mulana, it's not fard. I don't have to do it. Think of this hadith, and rather dispel that negative thought and change it into a positive one. Think of that action as a golden opportunity to meet your Nabi.